In this episode, I'm going to show you how to build a flyout effect on the GrandMA3 software from scratch. Last episode, we used a macro to load some predefined effects. We have them right here. If you missed that one, that's episode 10. You can find that on our playlist. But in this episode, I think we should try to build a flyout effect from scratch to better understand what is happening when you do so. So first of all, let's open our Phaser editor. We go into our common window in here and add the Phaser editor. I'm going to make this a little bit smaller because we need another step bar, which we find down here, right here. This is the different programming steps we can use when we program the Phaser. To build our flyout effect, we need two steps. The first step is dimmer at zero and the first position. The next step is dimmer at full and the second position. So let's start by building the first one. We choose all our vipers. We go down into dimmer and we set the dimmer value at zero for step one. Then we go into step number two. And we select our dimmer again and we set it to full. Now the dimmer effect starts to pulsate. We go back into step number one and deselect step number two and we select our position down here and we press the button down here and we find our presets and say, okay, our position number one, I think I'll choose my position number one for that one. So right now it goes into position number one. Then we select step two and we deselect step one. We go back into pan and tilt and we select our roof position. Now the effect starts moving, but it doesn't really look like a flyout yet because we have to edit some different things in here. You can see the pan, we can see the tilt here, and we can see the dimmer values up here. We need to have a different dimmer curve on the dimmer. So we deselect the pan and we deselect the tilt, and we go into this one down here, and we select a hard cut for the dimmer effect. So right now it snaps on and it snaps off. So basically now we already built a cool flyout. So we need to space it out a little bit. So we select everything again, and then we go into our phase down here and we select 0 through 360, for instance, and then you can see a nice flyout. So that's how easy it is to build a flyout effect on the GrandMA3 software. You can start playing with the phase. You can do all kinds of things. We haven't touched GrandMA tricks yet in this tutorial series, but there you can randomize the way it moves when it applies the phase. Let me just show you. If I go into MA tricks here and I go into shuffle and I just give it some random value and I apply the phase again, you can see it randomizes the flyout. So as you can see, it's quite easy to build a flyout effect from scratch. Please give the video a like if you learned something and subscribe to the channel if you don't want to miss any future episodes. See you next time. Bye bye.